The government of Uganda secured funding in the amount of $75 million from the World Bank for the financing of the project. Uganda is the 8th African country to benefit from this initiative, which aims at helping address the region's connectivity constraints. Other countries that have already benefited from the initiative include Kenya, Burundi, Madagascar, Rwanda, Tanzania, Mozambique, Malawi and Comoros. Speaking during the launch in Kabale, Colin Babirukamu, the director of e-government services at NITAU, noted that the infrastructure has been extended to over 39 ministries, departments and agencies, hospitals and schools within Kigezi sub-region, and this has greatly improved service delivery. He said that transmission sites amplify broadband signal from one point to another and enable broadband access to entities within the district or region.
Yeah, obviously, is to make sure that Kigezi region is fully connected. We are talking about hospitals, we are talking about schools, local government offices, government agencies. Our desire is to have Kigezi area, Kabale, but also the Kigezi area, fully connected. And of course, ensuring that we have very easy cross-border trade with our neighbors in Rwanda. As you have seen in Katuna, our services now are making cross-border trade very, very quick and easy.
In his message, the Minister for ICT and National Guidance, Dr. Chris Waliomunsi, implored local political leaders and representatives of government institutions to embrace the use of ICT within their operational environments to ensure efficient and public service delivery. He was represented by Nelson Shanga Basheja, the Kabale District Chairperson at the function.
ICT sector has over the years been vibrant and dynamic. It has now turned into an invaluable tool for social economic development as the government of Uganda. We are profoundly honored to lift off yet this great milestone in economic development of this country. Over the years, government of Uganda has authorized ICT as a catalyst not only of improving its efficiencies and the cost of doing business, but overall social and economic empowerment of Uganda.
According to Jones Murangira, the Kabale University ICT Director, the university has been able to facilitate e-learning with the extension of this project there. Murangira said that the university has been able to rank as the 9th in Uganda due to increasing digital efforts.
Has been very successful, especially in times of COVID. Online exams are able to be conducted. When you reach Kabale University, Wi-Fi is all over the place. Students, staff, the general community are able to access service using their mobile devices. Before the coming of NITA, the cost for internet were absolutely so high. We used to rely on commercial service providers. And commercial service providers were giving service which is not up to date, which was still wanting, in spite of the monthly high cost for it.
However, Murangira said NITAU needs to think about reducing the cost of the internet, which is still a bit high.
Currently, NITAU is charging $70 per megabyte of bandwidth. That's the capacity. And if you are to take a closer look at the market, some service providers are charging as low as $20. So my appeal to the government is to ensure that educational institutions are subsidized. The cost need to be brought much, much lower, below $10.
The program aims to support the government of Uganda in improving coverage for IT infrastructure in the country, the delivery of public services by improving efficiency through government cloud infrastructure, integration of government IT systems, building capacity in management of IT programs and projects, and improving policy and regulatory environment for ICT in the country. Story by Job Namanya for the news in Kabale.